Hi, everybody, and welcome once again to WCW Prime Wrestling. I'm Gordon Solie, and it's a pleasure to be here for the first time on this program, along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. And I'll tell you what, last Sunday night, that was the biggest surprise I'd ever had in my life at the Hall of Fame thing.
Well, let me tell you, Gordon Solie, going into the Hall of Fame, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, I was ecstatic, but they had whispered in my ear for months, talked about inducting my man, Gordon Solie, the Dean, into the Hall of Fame. Nobody deserved it more than you. Bad blood went down that night. We got bad blood flowing today on the Prime. But, you know, I told all the fans, big mooing going on today for the Prime matchup. But most of all, I say, you know, sooner or later, I'm going to get some really great anchor on here with me to do this color. And the Dean is standing with the magazine. I'm going to have fun today. I'm going to tell the most story about you and old.
No, we won't talk about that, that's for sure. I'll tell you what, some of the great competitors we'll be seeing include Kevin Sullivan, Bunkhouse Buck, Dirty Dick Slater, Craig Pittman, Sergeant Craig Pittman, Johnny B. Bad. The whole thing. I'll tell you what, though, let's go to our first match right now. We're going to be seeing Alex Wright in action. Let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Nuremberg, Germany, weighing 235 pounds, Germany's youngest professional wrestler, Das Wonder King, Alex Wright.
Second generation wrestler, his dad, the famous John Wright from Germany. Both of them graduates, if you will, from the Wigan School of Wrestling in England. And they are a submission specialist school. So let's go back to our ring announcer.
His opponent from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, weighing 235 pounds, Rick Thames.
Why, Dusty, with a name like Thames, is it Thames or Thames?
I don't know which one it is, but I'm still trying to figure out where the Wigan School of Wrestling is. I wonder if it's like our power plant right here, you know, WCW Prime. And what a treat to be sitting here with Hall of Famer, the man himself, the Dean, Gordon Solie, right here with Dusty Rhodes, whether it's Times, Thames, or whatever. He got his work cut out for him because the Wonder Kid has been on a real win streak, Gordon.
Ooh, a bit of an insult here by Thames or Thames or whatever his name is. He sort of spit on the ring mat. That's not a very nice thing.
No, it's not. It's not nice and not very sanitary. You know
right
what I'm
there.
Talking about? I'm telling you, what a great thing we got going here with the man, Gordon Solie, American Dream, back together here. We've had a colleague before, you know, I won't mention his name, but it's so good to be in here with just Gordon Solie so I can talk and say what I want to say.
Just the two of us. Thames is really beginning to punish Alex Wright. Wright, who had an unblemished record until he faced Arn Anderson for the World Television, got a beautiful backside play by Wright, and he hooks into an inside armbar.
Well, God, you know that's true. You know, keeping that record unblemished was going to be hard. We knew that for him. Such a young man who's got a lot of ability and everything against a guy like the enforcing guy that he stepped up to the plate against. But you ain't going to learn unless you lose one or two. You ain't going to learn. You know, if I won them all, I would never be in the Hall of Fame with yours truly, Gordon Solie. But he's in a learning process, 19, I think, 20 years old. Great move. I mean, this kid's got it all in front of him, Gordon.
Yeah, he does. Nice fireman carry. Takedown, Justin. He really does. He's got those long, ropey muscles. Very sinewy, however.
Who? Very what?
Sinewy.
Very sinewy.
And that's not like sinunu. That's sinewy.
Yeah, but, okay, I know now, nice shot. Being with Gordon on the Prime, I'm going to need a dictionary. I know that now. I understand, because that's Gordism, the wholehearted understanding roadism.
Once again, he's got an armbar down on Thames and keeping him under control. I got to say, and you're right, I think the loss for Alex Wright was a good seasoning process for him.
Well, sure it is. You know, you never know that you can be beat until you're beat. And you stepped up in competition, and the Wonder Kid is the kind that can take this. It doesn't seem to, it bothers you, but it doesn't seem to really keep him from, you know, doing what he's doing right now, because he stepped right back in there against a tough opponent. And, you know, I know this is one half of the Southern Posse right here. And as a tag team, they're very, very mean and angry and angry. And right here in there by himself, he wants to win this thing too, because he's seen this kid upset.
And, boy, he hooked him.
hook to the left hand that time that staggers Alex Wright. Alex Wright, those eyes slightly crossed, smashed into the turnbuckle. He's got himself some props. He catches another one right in the temple, and another one just above the ear, and then a boot to the midsection. Man, he is loose some heavy artillery.
Yes, he is, and he's out for a victory right here on Prime. He knows that Prime is all over the country, all over the world, and more of any program he'd rather get a victory on, it'd be WCW Prime, because someday he would want me to move in that Prime Cut match of the week.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I've never stood alongside of you when that occurrence took place, but it's going to be a treat, I'm sure.
Well, God, I know after your victory party, I'll stand alongside of you. After you got inducted to the Hall of Fame and me got inducted, I know we both felt like mooing there later on in the night.
And that's mooing, folks, not mooning.
Yeah.
Mooing.
Moon. Oh, well, I would have mooned too. You
know? Old days of Yee Haw Junction.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yep.
Alex Wright exploded that time with a hard right hand. Went to come in for a shoulder smash to the midsection. Was successful. Then into a full power slam and down across his man. Hooks the far leg, but couldn't get the pair.
That was a little light cover by him. I'd like to see him hit him a little, go in there a little deep and hook that leg up.
Caught with the back of the elbow, and Thames has got himself some problems now. Irish whip back into the turnbuckle. Once again, here comes Alex Wright. Back flips away. I need that one explained.
Well, you just have to, I think he's trying to, it's like the other night at the party when I did the backflip off the cocktail table.
Yeah.
It's the same thing. You're just trying to get attention.
Well, you got attention, that's for sure. That was a heck of a party. Right now, moving up on that top rope, squares off, flies across, double ox handle into the head of Mr. Thames, and he's down. Here's where Alex ought to really sit down and get into his man rather than walk around.
Yeah, I think he knows he got it in the back. Nice belly in the back. Is that right?
Yes, sir. Semi bridge on that one. He gets the pinfall.
Yeah,
no, he didn't get the pinfall.
No, he was calling for the helicopter.
Yep.
Here he is. Whoa, I got him.
Flying cross body block. Alex Wright gets the victory. And so this man bounces right back after his loss to Arn Anderson. He's back on the victory trail. And we'll be back with more action after this.